I've been playing around with the new version of the cumulative delta indicator, and I found a great little combination that I wanted to share. This histogram right here, this is the cumulative delta histogram, and this indicator is also painting these background colors and the candle colors. This histogram down here is the W Wave Pro, and that indicator is also printing these buy and sell signals. On the settings for the cumulative delta, I've left everything the same as it is right out of the box, except I have unchecked the plot cumulative delta, and I have unchecked the plot moving median. The only thing that I have plotted is the difference, which is this histogram that I really wanted to focus on being able to see clearly. So everything else was left the same. I unchecked the markers. There's no markers besides what's printed by the W Wave Volume Pro, just to make it clear and not confusing. And for the difference plot, I chose match data series width. I checked that box. That will thicken up the bar lines here and adjust it accordingly to your candlesticks. If you stretch out your charts and your candlesticks, the histogram will change the width appropriately. Today is August 28th. We're coming into the close of the US session. Some great moves right at the close here. You can see our cumulative delta is painting these backgrounds and the colors, really helping us define uptrends and downtrends for the short term. This is a 1 minute NASDAQ chart. So what I'm looking for with this duo is to see a W wave indicator print, and I want the background of the cumulative delta to be corresponding. So if there's a signal short, I want the background to be going short on the cumulative delta as well. And likewise with the longs. With this signal back here a little after 1 o'clock, we're kind of in the in-between zone here. We're not in an uptrend or a downtrend on the cumulative delta, but our histogram is bearish. And then once the background of the cumulative delta indicator turns bearish, we can look to enter a trade. This W wave signal printed while we were already in an uptrend on the cumulative delta, so that was a good signal. If we go back to the beginning of the day for the market open, kind of spread this out so it's easier to see. Here's 9:30. We get a W wave signal to the downside, but our cumulative delta is green, so that is a no trade. We're not looking to take these down signals when the cumulative delta is green. 4 minutes in, we get our first signal. Our W wave signal is long, our cumulative delta is long, and we had a nice 20 plus point move there. We get a W wave signal to the downside, but we're not interested right now because our cumulative delta is still green. 13 minutes in, the cumulative delta is turning bearish. We get a W wave signal to the upside, which we are not interested in, as our cumulative delta is bearish now. But at 9:51, we get a W wave signal to the downside. Now that we are in alignment with the cumulative delta, we can get short. And that was over a 30 point move to the downside there. We get another W wave signal going long, but we're not gonna take it. Cumulative delta is still bearish. And then we just kind of chop around for a while, and you can see our cumulative delta kind of stays in this gray zone. It's neither bearish or bullish with the printed background color here, but we don't actually get a corresponding signal until 10:40. And then the very next candle, we are bearish on our cumulative delta, and we've had this W wave signal. Great place to get short there. Another 30 point drop in 5 minutes. And now we're coming up to 11 o'clock when I'm done trading for the day. Another thing I like to look out for, especially when it's in a more of a trending market. I like to look at this cumulative delta histogram and look for divergences. Here you can see the price makes this low, and then it continues to make another low, yet our cumulative delta histogram is a little bit higher. So when I'm seeing divergence in the cumulative delta histogram, definitely keeping my eye open for possible retracements. And we did get a little bounce up right there. So this is Friday last week, right here, New York open. We've got cumulative delta going up. We've got a W wave signal. We had some bigger moves on Friday, and even though we were kind of ranging most of the morning, we would have bought at the close of this candle. There's still a 20 point move within 6 or 7 minutes. This W wave signal we would ignore because of the green background from the cumulative delta. We want everything in alignment. Here's another possible buy opportunity. We really were ranging for most of the morning, so it took about 20 minutes, but it popped up over 60 points. This W wave signal we would ignore because we have the green cumulative delta background. This W wave signal, we are in kind of a gray zone. It's neither bullish or bearish on the cumulative delta. But if we waited till a little bit after 10, we get a W wave signal to the downside. And the very next candle, our cumulative delta turns bearish as well. That's a 30 point drop in 2 minutes right there. Doesn't look like much on the screen, but that's 30 points in 2 minutes right there. This W wave signal we ignore. The background is bearish on the cumulative delta now. And these two signals, we would be interested in taking W wave signals to the downside. The NASDAQ really dropped off for the rest of the morning. Managed to come down another 150 points or so by 11 o'clock. And last week, at the end of the week on Friday, just wanted to show you some more divergence. See, we have price going up, but our cumulative delta histogram is lower. So we're definitely on the eye for potential reversals, as this cumulative delta is not rising with the price rising. And same on the way down, we had this big move down, but you'll notice our cumulative delta histogram is going up and up, and then finally we get a nice reversal. Even over here, see right there, we have our histogram up here. We make new highs in price, but our cumulative delta histogram is lower. And so we've got the divergence there. And then we have a correction to the downside in price. So just another way to use this indicator. I always like to look out for divergences. And the cumulative delta is a great indicator to pay attention to for divergences. This new updated version of the cumulative delta indicator is definitely something special. It's not like anything else out there on the market. NinjaTrader has definitely put a few of their custom touches on it and made it unique. I also wanted to share this trick that's helpful for me when I'm working on playing with new indicators or checking out an indicator and I'm not sure if I want to incorporate it into my main system yet, or I kind of want to, you know, keep an eye on the cumulative delta, the W wave signals, but I still want to trade my main system and I don't want to apply both of these indicators to my other chart and have it be way too confusing. So something that I do is if you right click on your chart, click on properties, scroll down to the bottom, you can uncheck the show tabs, which will get rid of this tab at the bottom of the screen and give you more chart space. Then you can check always on top. And that will keep this window on top no matter if I'm clicking on my other chart behind it. This chart will stay right on top of everything, so I'll always be able to see it. So I can be using ChartTrader in the background on my main chart, and entering orders, and this will still stay in the foreground, so I can kind of keep an eye on it. I can move it around to somewhere that's out of the way at the moment, and then if I need to see the bigger picture on this chart, I can just expand it for a second, look at it a little bit bigger, then kind of tuck it back away out of sight, and be able to keep my eye on the current price action on my main chart, and also get a little snapshot idea of what's happening with this duo right here, or any other indicators that you might be wanting to kind of get a feel for while you're still trading your system. I've really been enjoying this combination so far. I always like to have delta in my systems and volume as well, so this has been a great duo. It's definitely been helping me with added confirmation when I'm looking to get into a trade.